Here, hold my periscope. Yeah, seven people are.
So you should be the next one, huh?
There's too many people. Ask Cody.
Huh?
Ask Cody.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Right. Sure. Push either, yeah. Is it? Hey, hold my phone.
Yeah. running up to.
The marriage altar with the support and blessings of their family and friends, and especially their parents, who has the honor of presenting this woman to be married to this man. Arnold and Natalie, I've been to a lot of beautiful weddings, but this is the first time I've been up and close and personal. So I thank you for this privilege. I am so happy for the photography and excited to see how each of you will grow within this marriage union. It is so cool that you have found the person you would like to be married to for the rest of your life. It is a very precious thing, and I hope that you cherish it and fully invest in it. This marriage, you bring your love as a gift to each other. You bring your hopes and dreams to share together. You bring your gifts and talents, your unique personalities and spirits as you build your life together. We celebrate with you in thankfulness to the Lord for creating this union of hearts built on friendship, respect, and love. It was God who first created marriage when he saw and stated that it was not good for man to be alone, and so made a partner for him in the form of a woman. So I'd like to acknowledge him and pray for you both in your marriage. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, what a beautiful day that you have created as a day to celebrate Arnold and Natalie's wedding. I thank you for how you have created them as individuals, and how you have loved and cared for them throughout their lives. I thank you for how you have prepared them for each other. I pray for them, Lord, as they start this new life together as husband and wife. May they show each other the same love and grace that you have shown them. May they experience your blessing in this marriage and share it with those around them. I pray that they would know your love and goodness in their marriage and in their lives, and praise you. You are good and worthy to be praised. In Jesus' name. As you stand before family and friends and in God's presence, I ask you both to remember that love and commitment will serve as the foundations for your marriage. A definition of love that I heard recently stated that love is a commitment of the will to seek the very best interests of the other at the expense of your own. It's love that propels you to commit to this. It's commitment of the will, because many times you won't want to put the other's interests at the expense of your own. So while I pray that you continue to nurture your love for each other, I pray that you also stand upon the commitment you make to each other. So I ask each of you now about the commitment you will make to each other. Arnold, will you have Natalie to be your wife? Will you love her as a person, respect her as an equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, and triumph as well as defeat, and commit to work in this marriage as long as you both shall live? Natalie, will you have Arnold to be your husband? Will you love him as a person, respect him as equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, and triumph as well as defeat, and commit to work in this marriage as long as you both shall live? To have and to hold from this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. And to that I pledge you my love and faithfulness. Natalie, repeat after me. I, Natalie, take you, Arnold, to be my husband. Have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. And to that I pledge you my love and faithfulness. The ring is a symbol of the commitment which binds you two together. There are two rings because you are two. Each to make a contribution to life of the other and to your new life together. Okay, so Arnold. Put it on. Repeat it. I give you this ring as I give you myself. Love and affection. Arnold, today you are making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your lives with each other. Your relationship is symbolized through the blending of these individual wines. This Syrah represents you, Arnold. Burly, rugged, bold, fruity, and a little spicy. And this Pinot Noir represents you, Natalie. Elegant, refined, soft, earthy, and complex. Each wine holds its own beauty and character and can stand on its own without needing anything else. However, blended together, they create an extraordinary and more intricate entity. By blending together, virtues are accentuated and weak points diminished. The Pinot Noir can tame Syrah's innate aggressiveness and accents the fruit, while Syrah gives Pinot Noir for structure and increases the complexity. Just as the two wines can never be separated and put back into their separate containers, so your marriage will be two individuals bonded together in one heart. Please pour the wines together in the unity glass to symbolize the union of your two lives. With this, always remember your lives together will be deeper, richer, and more satisfying, just as this newly blended wine. You are no longer two independent persons, but one. By the power given to me by God in the state of California, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride. I now have the honor and privilege to be the first to present to all of you Mr. and Mrs. Arnold Chu.
And although it's a very special day for my family, this is a special day for Natalie because she's married to the one that she loves. And I said, this is a special day for my family because Natalie is the first one of a generation in a family. To marry. And I hope, I sincerely hope, that her wedding today can bring more wedding to my family.
They came all the way from Hong Kong to attend this wedding. So, since we're hosting all these out-of-town guests in our house, last night I was kicked out of my own room. I had to spend the night in my sister's room. And in my sister's room, I saw something that I would like to share. So there's this bear. 21 years ago, I went to a summer school in England, and I was young and ignorant back then. The storekeeper tricked me, saying that this was Mr. Bean's teddy bear, so I bought it for my sister as a souvenir. So when I got home, my sister obviously knew this was not Mr. Bean's teddy bear, but she entertained me and named him Bean Bean Bear. And also, just that you guys knew, he was a strong contender to be a ring bearer today. Which, at the end, Ender, awesome Ender, won the position by a small margin. So, I also like to welcome Arnold to be part of the family. Although, I know he's always felt like a part of the family already for the past 3 years. He's been having dinner at my house, like with my family, almost every night. And it's actually a good thing that he was there because makes me less guilty for eating a pound of spaghetti and eating because he would do the same. But for our defense, my sister Natalie, she makes the best spaghetti. It's like master chef level. So now I'm kind of jealous of Arnold, who gets to have spaghetti for dinner every night. So I guess now can officially welcome Arnold. Be part of the family. And toast Natalie and Arnold. So one more thing to tell Arnold. The LEGO VIP membership is actually free. I've been tricking you all these times so that you stick me up your point.